All right, relax. I'm not here to hurt you.
You already have.
We had to get you here somehow.
You could have asked.
Right.
But that usually doesn't go over very well. This is easier.
Just kill me and get it over with.
Sure. After you tell me the story. From the beginning.
There is no story. It's just me and her.
Well, we don't care about you, just her. Tell me about her.
Her.
Marie.
My Marie. The sunshine of my life. A lot has changed.
Tell me.
I had gotten off work early for the first time in months.
I was walking home with a spring in my step. Unusual for me, I'm afraid. I was eager to get home to my Marie, you see. She never gets lonely, but I sure do. She always seems to know exactly how to fill that space in my chest. I was stepping up my apartment staircase, still humming that tune, when I realized something was amiss. The building was quiet. Too quiet.
Marie? I'm home. Is everything okay?
Suddenly from the other room, a thunderous bump rattled the furniture.
Marie?
I tore down past our living room into our kitchen, expecting the worst. I skidded to a halt. My limbs froze, my heart hammering. My Marie. My Marie, a demon soaked with blood. The kitchenette was a pool of it, thick and crimson, creeping along the chilled plastic. The body of a man I didn't know lied between us, with no qualms of being the elephant in the room.
Kyle, you're home early.
Marie? What? Who?
My secret lover. Kyle? Would you be a dear and bring me the mop and bucket from the closet?
A numbness thrilled down my spine.
Yeah. Sure. Of course.
I felt like I was in a horrible daydream where up is down and down is up. Everything was sideways and far off and falling in between. How many times has this mop been a double agent of secrets? How long has this bucket been a well of last words and dead men? I came back to myself then.
Thank you, dear. We need to clean this up extra nice for the authorities.
Hit by a lightning bolt thrust by the might of Zeus.
Marie, you killed a man. How long? How long have you been a sick murderer? And why didn't I know?
Minor details, dear. I've had a fever since the day I was born.
I should call the police.
But you won't. Because I love you. And you love me.
It was then, while I was looking down that barrel, that I realized
now,
that she was right.
I want you to be a good boy and help me clean this mess, okay?
I did love her.
Would you do that for me?
She was so poised, still so beautiful, like the Marie I always knew. I tried to fear her, to feel some sort of remorse or disgust. She would look at me sometimes, you know. Just a look, with some deep meaning within the depths of her gray scale heart, as if to cover all the secrets, all the skeletons in the closet.
That's it.
And I just knew.
That's all it takes.
I wasn't coming out of this alive.
How did you get away?
I didn't.
Then how are you here? Where's Marie?
Minor details.
She's dead. I killed her.
Forgive me for not believing you, but you love that woman more than you do yourself.
Yeah. And that's why I killed her.
Well then. I guess you got more guts than all the men in the world combined.
That's it? How do you know I wasn't lying?
We'll need to know where you decide to toss the body, of course. Our own investigation.
I'll let you know.
We can't have her alive. You should know that more than any of us.
Yeah.
Good. Then we'll be in touch.
That's it. That's all it takes. Why are you doing this?
You do the same.
Yes, but you're not me.
I...
Clean everything up. Remember what I told you. Remember all the minor details. I'm sorry. Mm-hmm.